UAPB Golden Lions hosting the Southern University Jaguars. It's the number one team in the SWAC in the Jaguars and the number three team in the SWAC in the UAPB Golden Lions. And Carlos, the Golden Lions have developed chemistry. They've been playing very, very well together here as of late, and they have four wins in a row in conference play, and they are pretty much firing on all cylinders right now.
It's actually huge for Coach Solo, you know, to get his team going, get them in a rhythm. Everybody's been waiting to see his type of team play, and it looks like they're beginning to come into their own with some, you know, a lot of fluidity. They're shooting the ball well. They're getting the ball down low sometimes when they need to. So, you know, Coach Solo got him rolling right now. You know, he's one of those guys you want to root for anyway. He's
right.
A high-energy
guy. He's a good guy, man.
He gives us all. His coaching staff works hard. And now they begin to see some of the fruits of their labor.
Absolutely. And we talked about earlier in the season, Coach, talking about getting shots up. Coach Solomon Bozeman loves to get that three-point shot up. Yeah. The guys have been doing a great job, shooting a pretty good percentage from the three-point land on the season. Don't have the numbers right in front of me, but they've been doing pretty well shooting threes. And another thing, like you said, getting the ball inside and the emergence of Kylan Milton. We've been waiting all season for that third scorer. We talk about, of course, Sean Dawes Jr. is going to get his points. Chris Green, he shoots very well, usually gets his points.
Yeah.
But Kylan Milton kind of makes his team go.
Yeah, Kylan Milton has to go. I mean, you know, a point guard that goes, I think he's like 6'6", point guard. He can get any shot he wants to get. And to be honest with you, playing for somebody like Coach Bozeman wants you to drive, penetrate,
right, right.
Shoot. He wants you to get up and down the court and shoot the three and things like that. So, you know, if Kylan can continue to be aggressive as he's been over the last couple of games, you'll start to see the Golden Line continue to win ball games because he's been the X factor here lately.
Absolutely. We'll see if he can get going tonight, and the Golden Lions are going to need it as the Southern University Jaguars undefeated in conference play, 5-0. So they're playing very well as well. And Coach Sean Woods, he's in his fifth season. He does a tremendous job with this team and getting them up and down the court and just winning ball games. They know how to win ball games, and that is a learned ability, Coach. You can't, a lot of times you don't just come in knowing how to win games, but Southern has kind of mastered that feat so far this year.
Yeah, I mean, you know, the head man for the Jags is a former Kentucky Wildcat. He
right.
played under Tubbs, if I'm not mistaken, at Kentucky. So, you know, he comes with a winning pedigree as it is, and then he's been able to get guys that can run that offense. They, too, run up and down the court,
right.
just like Coach Bozeman's team, and shoot the three and try to get the ball down low when they get a lead as well. So it's two contrasting styles, you know, today, and I think it's going to be a great ball game.
Absolutely. We're looking forward to it. Of course, Coach Solomon Bozeman in his second season
yes.
here with the Golden Lions. And, man, he's made strides in the 2 years he's been here. And, of course, I think it kind of caught him off guard when he first got here. I don't think he kind of knew what to expect coming out of SWAC basketball.
Well, all of us as coaches coming into the SWAC, we have a little bit of disrespect for it when you first hear about SWAC. But when you come in there, you figure out that these teams are very talented.
Right.
You know, and you have it takes time to build. And most of the time, you know, with going back to Coach Bowman being his second year, you usually don't see any progression until year three.
Right.
You know,
right.
so he's ahead of schedule right. here being 4-1 right here and hopefully to go 5-1 and take control of first place in the SWAC.
And we'll see if they can do exactly that. Again, sitting at 4-2 in conference play in the number three spot, yes. And Alcorn's at 4-1.
Gotcha.
And, of course, we need this big win. That'll put it, depending on what Alcorn does tonight, and we'll keep you updated on those games as well. All right, starting lineups for the two teams. For the visiting Jaguars, you have number 0, Terrell Williams, a 6'6", 210-pound redshirt junior from Arlington, Texas. 6'1", 175-pound senior guard out of Houston, Texas, P.J. Byrd. He's wearing number 3. Number 12, Jalen Reynolds. He's 6'6", forward, wearing 245 pounds, a junior from Dalton, Georgia. And number 22, Breon Whitley, 6'4", guard, 200-pound graduate student from Sarasota, Florida. And number 23, Bryson Etienne. For the Golden Lions, number 0, Trajan Ware. 21, Sean Dawes Jr. Number 22, Robert Lewis, getting the start today, as well as number 24, A.C. Curry. And in the middle, number 45, Ishmael Plett. Definitely going to need a big game out of him as well, as he's really our only true post player.
Yeah, I think you'll probably see Caleb Stokes as well. He's a 6'8 junior out of Little Rock, transferred in from SAU Tech. I seen him for the first time, you know, this semester out on the court
okay.
in warm-ups.
So maybe we'll see him this evening. All right, we're underway here, and Southern controls the tip. They'll have it first. swinging it around the perimeter. As Coach Jones yells out instructions from his bench. Here's a screen play. P.J. Bird has it, swings it across court.
Oh, nice steal by Doss right there.
Son Doss takes it up court, has a man behind him. He's going to pull it out, kicks it out to Ware.
Doss actually stole that ball. He's getting ready to take a jumper. And as he went up with the ball, Doss just took it.
Oh, wow. Nice play there by Son Doss Jr. He has it on the right wing. Back out to Ware, who has played some valuable minutes for the Golden Lions as well. Ware has it stripped away momentarily, loses the handle again, and that's going to be a turnover by Trajan Ware.
Yeah, and you talk about Doss a little bit. His second return to UAPB has been a really good one.
It has.
He went off and got some experience at, I think it was Southeast Missouri State, if I'm not mistaken.
Southern Illinois. Evansville, I believe.
Yeah, it was an all-conference player.
Yes.
And he come back here, come back home, and he's been leading the Golden Lions.
Right, a lot more maturity since he's
returned. He has.
Here's a great defense by the Golden Lions. A trap in the corner. It results in a turnover, and the Golden Lions will have it.
And mind you, we got a packed house.
Yes, sir.
It is packed. Only way you can sit now is probably with the band.
And shouts out to all the Golden Lion fans out there that weren't able to make it to the game, tuned in to the Reliance Bank broadcast. We definitely appreciate that. LaRon Marbley here with Carlos James. Inside pass to Ishmael Plett. High off the glass is good. Assist by Son Doss Jr.
Yeah, again, that's when we talk about Doss's maturity level. He lets the game come to him now.
So the first score on the board, Golden Lions lead 2-0. Just underway here from the H.O. Clemens Arena. Here's a drive on the baseline. And our first whistle on a foul for today. And it's going to be called on Robert Lewis.
I remember they used to wouldn't call them fouls on the baseline like that. You can get beat up down there.
Right.
But now, you know, any little contact going to the base, because the ball, the guy that's had the ball, he don't have nowhere to go.
So the shot, three-point attempt is blocked by Son Doss Jr. And Southern ends up with it. Terrell Williams has it, swings it out. This is Whitney, kicks it out. Here's a three-point attempt, no good. Rebound, Trajan Ware. That shot was missed by Etienne. Ware will push it up court, swings it over to Plett. Plett dribbles over, hands off to Doss. Screen by Robert Lewis, and that's going to be a legal screen. Good call there. As he kind of turned his back and leaned into him.
Yeah.
That was a good call by the officials. That's his second personal foul early on in this game.
Yeah, you know, Lewis is one of my favorite guys. You know, being a freshman, his size, I think he has a chance to be really, really good in the coming years.
He actually had he got signed out of the King Cotton Classic last year.
Okay.
Played with Cardinal Ritter.
Okay.
Not this past season, but the prior season.
Well, the King Cotton now back paying good dividends.
Yes, sir. Here's the move, and the short jump hook is no good. Rebound by A.C. Curry. That shot was missed by Jalen Reynolds. And here comes Ware. He's going to attack. Scoop shot is good. Trajan Ware with the basket. Nice screen there by Robert Lewis.
Yeah. Lewis did a great screen right there.
And here comes the Jags. They're going to attack. Kicks it back out after driving in the cup. Losing his balance. And the ball is loose. It's on the floor.
First down.
A scramble. And the Golden Lions come out with it. Here's Doss. Goes up. Has it raked away. And it's going to be a foul call. So that foul is on number 0, Terrell Williams, his first personal.
Two shots.
And that's the team first personal foul as well. Two shots for Son Doss Jr.
I know everybody was looking for Son Doss to rise right there and put that dunk like he did a couple of weeks ago.
Oh, wow.
Here at home against, I think it was, who was that they were playing? Texas Southern?
Either Texas Southern or Prairie View. I can't remember which game it was, as Doss was able to knock down the first free throw.
He posterized somebody.
He did. And, of course, he did that on his first trip when he was here in the beginning. That was kind of his moniker. Still doing it with Son Doss Jr., the grad student. Knocks down his second free throw. So the Golden Lions with a 6-0 lead here early on in the ball game. 17-25 remaining in this first half from the H.O. Clemens Arena. LaRon Marbley, Carlos James, Golden Lions, 4 straight conference wins. Looking for a 5th here today. Here's the give and go. And the Jags swinging it around, attacking the basket. Shot is blocked. Rebound by Robert Lewis. Nice defense there by A.C. Curry.
Right now, you're already seeing the Golden Lions are long.
Extremely.
lot taller than the Jaguars right now.
Ishmael Plett is going to attack. He is fouled. No call. But A.C. Curry right there. He may have got away with a travel.
Yeah.
They definitely got away with a foul. But Curry was there to make to clean it all up.
Yeah, great no call by the officials here. If it was that first game, we probably would have got some call.
There have been three fouls on that one play.
Yeah, all offensive.
Here's the three-point attempt. It is no good by Whitney.
It's going to be on Platt right there.
So that foul is indeed on Ishmael Platt, his first one, the team's third. As Tyrone Lyons and Isaiah Rollins enter for Southern. The Jags will inbound underneath their own goal. Have yet to score, trailing 8-0. Here's a mid-range jumper by Rollins. No good. Rebound. Shun. Check that. That's A.C. Curry. Hands it over to Ware. He'll bring it up court.
Yeah, Ware was taking his time. If you know Coach Bozeman, he wants that ball up the court and in the air.
Doss is going to take the mid-range jumper. He's fouled. He'll have two. That one's on number 12, Jalen Reynolds. That's his first personal and the second on the Jags. And Doss will head to the line for the second time here in this ball game.
Coach Woods is figuring out pretty quick. He's got to get some taller guys in here. And, you know, now we got Green about to check in, and he's one of our better shooters. And he goes 6'8".
Right. So nice shot there.
So Coach Woods brings somebody in tall, and Coach Bozeman goes bring somebody in taller.
First free throw good by Sean Doss Jr. As you mentioned, Green entered the game. And for the Jags, number 21, Festus Dumania.
And we've yet to see our guy that we talked about, Milton, as well.
Right. Doss, truth from the line. 10-0 is the score. Golden Lions leading. Again, great defensive effort starting out the ball game for the Golden Lions. Have yet to allow the Jags to score. Here's a mid-range jumper by P.J. Byrd. No good. Offensive board. And bringing it back out is the Jags.
Great defense by the Lions. Great defense. They are all over the. Kind of look like Nolan Richardson's old teams.
Here's a shot from the corner. No good. Contested by Sean Doss Jr. Rebound, A.C. Curry. Doss gets it up court. He's going to wisely pull it back out. Swings it across court to A.C. Curry. He takes the three from the corner, knocks it down. A.C. Curry from downtown.
Yeah, that's the basketball that Bozeman want to play right there.
13-0 our score. Golden Lions lead with 15:37 remaining in this opening half. We'll take a break, and we'll be back with more on the Lions main broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and Deltaplex Radio's 99.3 The Beat. Folks, they're turning up here in the H.O. Clemens Arena. Leroy Marbley, Carlos James, Golden Lions with a 13-0 lead to start this ball game with just over 15 and a half minutes remaining in the first half. And Carlos, you can't ask for anything better if you're the Golden Lions.
Yeah, just kick the extra point.
Right, to take a 14-0 lead. Absolutely. The Jags will bring it up. This is P.J. Byrd, swings it over to the right wing, back out top. This is Lions. He'll hand off back to Byrd. Byrd being guarded by Bram Harris. He'll swing it out top to Rollins. Over to the corner. Back out.
The Golden Lions are contesting every pass. Every pass.
Great tenacity on defense. Here's a three-point shot, and I didn't think he got it off.
I didn't think so either.
Nonetheless, the shot is no good. Rebounded by Sean Doss Jr. Curry gets it ahead. Back out to Ware. Ware gets a screen from Green. Of course, Green, one of the best shooters on this team. Graham Harris pulls it back out, swings it. Great ball movement by the Golden Lions. Doss has it. He's going to attack the basket, loses it, and that's a turnover. And there's again the steal. There's A.C. Curry with the steal. And wow. The foul is called from the baseline.
Yeah, that's unreal right there. The official that was right on the play didn't call it. Guy from the baseline made a call. He must have went to Southern.
Oh, the foul is on Southern, on number five. Okay. Okay.
That sounds better.
That makes more sense there. Okay.
Because if not, that was a Southern graduate call there. Because he was way on the baseline, so it's something that happened under the basket.
Jerrion Wilkins was called for the foul. Curry wide open in the right corner this time. Oh, misses it. Graham Harris getting up high. Rebound, wrestle for it. Curry has it. A wrestle, no whistle. Into the hands of Trajan Ware.
Count those.
Has it. He's going to take the three, and it is short. Curry with the tip, and there's a foul call.
Yeah. Great, great job by the Lions, man.
A lot of action going around,
yeah. But the Golden Lions are playing with a lot of energy, man.
Yes, sir, they are. Festus Dumania called for his first personal. That's going to be the team's third. As Chris Green drives, and that's going to be a travel. Can't take it two steps and stop.
Well, actually, he was held. He was held. The defender did a good job of holding that left arm where the official couldn't see him because he tried to go up, and he just couldn't.
And that's what you do. You go up and throw your hands up.
Yeah.
You got to throw your hands up. Yeah. You know. We need to put Chris Green in a few drummer classes over in mass communications over there.
Yeah.
Here's Southern. They're coming up trailing 13-0, 14 minutes remaining in the first half. As Kylan Milton prepares to check in for the first time here today. Shot clock down to 7 seconds. Losing his balance is number 35, Tyrone Lyons. And it's going to be a jump ball. Possession goes to UAPB.
Great defense right there by the Golden Lions. Still shutting out the Jaguars here.
So Trajan Ware will come out the game. Well, check that. A.C. Curry comes out the game as Kylan Milton checks in. Four-court pressure by Southern. Doss to Harris, over to Ware, back to Harris. Breaking the press in the middle to Milton. Here's Doss attacking. He'll pull it back out. Graham Harris takes the three, and a little bit short there. Rebound by the Jags.
Yeah, he thought about it just a little too much.
Jalen Reynolds will bring it up, swings it over. Down to the left corner. Here's the left-hand jumper. It is good. That is Tyrone Lyons with the jumper. And the Jags on the board for the first time here this evening.
After 6 minutes of not scoring to start the game.
And the Jags get a turnover there. Approaching 13 minutes remaining in the first. Nice move there by Isaiah Rollins. Shot no good. Rebound Kylan Milton. Milton's going to push. Goes up court. Decides to pull it back out wisely. And swings it out top. Almost throws it away. Great catch there by Trajan Ware.
Yeah. New football coach need to get him on the
right.
Field. That was a great catch.
He almost threw that one to us.
No, we was going to catch
Chris
it.
Chris Green is going to take a deep three. No good. He's 0-for-2 from behind the arc. Rebounded by Deshaun Woods. Woods attacks. Gets it to the big man. He takes a mid-range jumper from the free throw line. No good. Trajan Ware comes out with the rebound. He'll bring it up. He'll attack. Decides to pull it back out. And Sean Doss is going to be one-on-one. Spin move. Doss. Nice move. Goes baseline. Has it thrown away.
Yeah, he's going to try to dunk that one.
Yeah, he was. Nice block there by Demania. And they're going to call a charging foul. Check that. A blocking foul on Chris Green.
Yeah, Doss was rising up. He was going to try to dunk that one. It was a great defensive play.
Dumania from Nigeria, 225 pounds, 6'7", junior. Jerron Wilkins enters for Southern, and A.C. Curry back in for the Golden Lions. 13-2 is our score with 12-14 remaining in this first half. Golden Lions have been on top since tip off. This is Jones with it. He'll hand off to Etienne. Etienne looking inside, throws it, and that ball is stolen by Platt. It's going to be a tie-up.
I was going to say intercepted.
And it's going to be a media timeout. When we resume, it'll be Southern's ball with 11:58 remaining in the first half. They trail 13-2. Go to Lions with an 11-point lead here on from the H.O. Clemens Arena. You're tuned into the Reliance Bank broadcast of Go to Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and Delta Flex Radio 99.3 The Beat. We'll be back in 1 minute. We're back in the H.O. Clemens Arena. Earlier, Lady Lions victorious as they knocked off the Lady Jags of Southern University. Big win for Coach Don Thornton. 70-53 was the final. Alabama A&M defeated Texas Southern in overtime, 72-69 in women's action. Alcorn defeated FAMU, 72-60. Jackson State over Bethune, 82-60. And Valley and Grambling still battling it out, 64-51 in that ball game for the women's team, as Alabama State leads in overtime with 23 seconds remaining, 73-72. As a call here is disagreed by, they called an offensive foul on Jerron Wilkins, his first personal. That's the third team foul. Check that, the fifth team foul. Missed a few there. Go to Lions will break the press here, leading 13-2. Looking for A.C. Curry. Bad pass there by Bram Harris.
I'm just looking at the scores. They said 13-3 on the printout, but it's 13-2 on the scoreboard. They've given Tyrone Lyons 3 points, three total points for the Golden Lions. So I don't know if which score is right at this point.
I believe the 11-point lead is correct, I believe. But, of course, we'll get that updated for you guys here pretty soon. Alabama State Prairie View women's is tied at 73 in overtime, 23 seconds left. Good game there. Go to Lions holding on to an 11-point lead as Southern has possession. Here's a trap here. Great defense by Trajan Ware. Turnover into the hands of A.C. Curry. Gets it up to Milton. Milton will slow it down. And again, tremendous defense here, man, by the Lady Lions and Go to Lions here,
yeah,
today.
Yeah, both teams have led from start to finish.
Yes. Milton kicks it out to Curry. He gives it back to Milton on the left wing. Swings it over to Ware, and they'll reset. Shot clock down to 10. Ware attacks, goes to the cup, swings it out to Curry. Takes the three, knocked. Oh, just missed. It's A.C. Curry. Rebound by Southern. Here's Woods. He'll pull it out as Coach Woods yells out instructions.
That's his son.
Right.
Yeah.
As you can hear the fans heckling them a little bit. Here's the shot, the left-hander. It's good. Nice shot there by Tyrone Lyons.
Yeah, Lyons has got all the Jaguars' points.
Which is 13-4, our score. Ware has it in the corner. Here's the trap. Timeout by the Golden Lions. We'll take a 30-second break as well. Golden Lions lead 13-4 with 10:26 remaining in this first half. This is Reliance Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and Delta Flex Radio's 99.3 The Beat. Lions holding on to a 9-point lead. 13-4 is our score with 10:26 remaining here in this first half. Some women's game still going on. Close one, 67-53, Grambling over Valley as the inbound pass goes to Ware. Over to Dawes to Curry. Curry's going to pull it back out to Milton. Ware goes baseline. Kicks it in to Plett. Plett goes up strong. Left-hand layup, Ishmael Plett.
Big basket right there.
And the lead swells to 11.
Two-minute drought there for the Lions.
Here's Southern. They're going to lose control of it and turn it over once again. So it'll go to the hands of the Golden Lions with 10:01 remaining in the first half. Full-court pressure by Southern. Looks like it's man-to-man. As Milton will get it, gets it back to Curry. Curry up to Doss. Doss across midcourt, swings it back to Curry. Milton drives baseline, pulls up, misses the jumper, a little bit short there, rebound by the Jags. This is Etienne bringing it up. He has it in the lane, almost has it stripped away, gets it to his teammate who's able to save it. Milton with a beautiful steal, taps it to Dawes. He goes up strong. Sean Dawes Jr. with the
great
finish.
Job. Great job by Dawes using his body in the rim to shield a defender and make the basket.
How about that steal and save by Milton over there? Turned around, tipped it backwards to his teammate who was flashing down the court in Dawes, and he was able to finish. 17-4 now our score. 13-point advantage for the Golden Lions. This is Wilkins in the post, makes a move, kicks
Should
it back
be three
out.
Seconds. Should be three
and
seconds.
And that's 3 seconds in the lane.
Yeah. Does he pivot there for about two? And by the time he passed the ball out, it was turnover city.
So the Golden Lions take over possession. Alabama State now leads in overtime with 6 seconds remaining over Prairie View, 76-74 in women's action. Full court pressure again by the Jags. Looks like man-to-man defense. Here's the trap in the corner on Trajan Ware. Dribbles, gets it out, and tips off the hand. Robert Lewis chases it down. Gives it in to Milton. Milton has it knocked away, and that's going to be a turnover.
One thing about it, they're letting them play.
I was just going to say that. Officials are letting them play. This is Wilkins. Fades away with the shot. No good. Robert Lewis up high for the rebound. They'll kick it out front to Dawson in the front court. He gets it inside to Plett. Plett going to work, goes baseline, has it stripped away, and that ball goes over to the Jags.
Yeah, Plett got it no man's land, trapped up under the basket right there.
Here's the Euro step and attack, no good, rebound Robert Lewis. 17-4 still our score, 8:15 remaining in the first half. As Kylan Milton will slow it down, Kosolo calls the play out. And Milton gets the screen from Plett, swings it over to Lewis, back out to Milton. Milton attacks, fakes the jumper. Lewis is going to take the three. Oh, in and out by Robert Lewis. Rebound. Southern, yes, that was a good shot. They push it ahead as Chris Green prepares to recheck in. And this will be P.J. Byrd. He drives toward the court. Pump fakes, spins.
Just threw that
acting
up.
Acting job, yes.
Yeah, he threw that up. He was trying to get a foul. Actually, he did
that
get foul, the foul.
Right. They called Trajan Ware for that foul.
That was really late, too. It was a late call.
His first personal and the team's fifth. Media timeout. We'll take one as well. 17-4 is our score. Golden Lions on top on their Lions Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and 99.3 The Beat. Oh. Ralph.
Go ahead. Yeah, hit Doc up there, yeah.
Yeah, tell my arm all the way up. Back inside the H.O. Clemens Arena, Golden Lions with a 17-4 lead here with 7:37 remaining in this first half. Ron Barbley, Carlos James, and man, it's been all Golden Lions thus far. You'd like to have seen them score a few more points, but with this 13-point lead, you got to be happy with it.
But they holding Southern is only shooting 12.5% from the field.
Wow.
So you don't have to score that many more points.
Right.
You could actually win this game 35-7.
This will be to the line. Will be the Jaguars as we resume action. First free throw is good.
That's the first Jaguar to score other than Lions.
P.J. Bird with his first points of the ball game. 6'1", 175-pound senior from Houston, Texas. He'll have one shot remaining. And the free throw is good. So 17-6 our score. And Carlos, you talked about it in the last game.
Yeah.
You definitely have to stay alert because teams like this, they're going to have their run sooner or later.
Oh, definitely. You don't become 5-0 for nothing.
Right. Absolutely. So Trey John Ware will pull it back out as you hear the crowd heckling the coach over here. This is Trey John Ware. Nice move, Trey John Ware, with the basket. And the quickness of Trey John Ware. And that foul is on Jaquan Ewing.
It's a great job by Trey John Ware. 5'9 sophomore out of Arkansas Baptist.
I love it.
From Pearland, Texas.
You know we call it Pearland.
Hey, I'm just trying to be proper, man.
Proper does not behoove you.
Pearland.
So the basket is good. Free throw is good. Trey John Ware with his fifth point. Golden Lions with a 14-point lead.
Every time I think about Parlin, I'm like, I bet not.
Here's the passes. Mid-range jumper. Nice contest by Chris Green. Rebound, Bram Harris. Here come the Golden Lions. Where? He'll bring it up court. Being guarded by Tyrone Lyons. Mismatch there. Lyons cannot stay in front of Ware.
At all.
Chris Green. Back cut by Doss. It's mishandled. It goes out of bounds.
Yeah, that was a tough pass in traffic right there.
Right. Two defenders there.
Yeah.
So the Jaguars wasting no time.
Yeah, we're hearing all the comments now.
And here's the ball thrown out, and it's turned over. Bram Harris has it. He loses control. He just picks it up. Looks inside to Doss, gets it to him, back out to Harris, and they'll just reset. And Coach Bozeman calling the play. Milton appeared to have caught the elbow or something to the back of the head. He was holding his head a moment ago. He'll get it on the right wing. He's going to attack. Swings it across to Doss. Doss thought about the three. He attacks baseline. Kicks it back out. Green has it. He's going to the cup. Nice move. Chris Green. And the layup is good. Just beating the shot clock is Chris Green. And the Golden Lions have a 22-6 lead with 6 minutes remaining. This will be Jerrion Wilkins with it. Swings it around. Southern's going to drive with Whitley. Down in the corner. Back out to Whitley. Willie pushes off there. He's going to take the mid-range jumper. It is no good. A battle for the rebound.
That should have been travel right there.
It should have been. And it's a jump ball here. It was two Golden Lions fighting for the rebound there.
Yeah, exactly. But as the Jaguar player that rebounded the ball, he fell and rolled all the way over.
Right.
Hey, make a decision, Sean. Make a damn decision.
Wow.
5:39 remaining in this first half, 22-6.
Those comments do not reflect the radio station.
Right. Disclaimer.
Yeah.
Here's where he's going to attack, and he's going to be fouled. And, of course, folks, they did move us over here to the student section.
Yeah. So you're going to hear some of everything.
That foul called on number 22, Breon Whitley.
And we cannot confirm or deny who that is.
Right. That's his first foul, and the 17th foul sent Trajan Ware to the line with 5.5 minutes exactly remaining here in this first half. First free throw is good by Ware.
Usually you get people jockeying, coaches. They don't have anything good to say, but there's been some good stuff coming out back behind.
Right, right.
All in fun.
Absolutely. Ware knocks down the second free throw. 24-6 our score. How big a lead is that?
It's a lot.
18-point lead.
You put me, I went the pile of high. You can't put me on point. We good at just coming right back with something.
Right.
Just to stall a little bit, you know?
Well, what you don't know is I was trying to add it up while I asked you that.
So that's why I said a lot.
A.C. Curry will return in the game. And Southern will have the possession here, trailing 24-6.
Hey, Sean, what the sweat, baby?
They'll inbound from the far sideline. And here comes Bird. Bird over to Lyons, who scored the bulk of the points for the Jags.
Yeah, he does. He has 95% of their points.
Pass long. Here's the three-point attempt. It is good. And that's Bryon Whitley knocking down the three.
That's the first clean shot that the Jags has got. Oh, that should be a foul.
And much of it credited to the Golden Lions defense. Here's Milton driving down the lane. Drops it off to Green. Green has it blocked from behind. And this will go off of Southern. And Green did not see the defender behind him.
Yeah, you got to go up strong with that.
And the ball will belong to the Golden Lions. Ishmael Platt will return. He'll give Green a break.
One of the Green, you know, he's been kind of off. By him being a starter, he's starting to get used to probably coming off the bench right there.
Now, it's farewell for Kylan Milton.
Yeah.
Again, every player is different. But Milton has come off the bench and has been spectacular as he swings it over to Harris. Takes the three with 2 seconds left on the shot clock. Offensive board by Ishmael Platt. Dawson's going to take a three and knocks it down. Sean Dawson Jr. from downtown.
Yeah, his first basket. I mean, it was 9 points, actually. But he's let the game come to him.
4:16 remaining in the half. 27-9 to score. Here's the shot. It is good. That's a two-pointer by P.J. Bird. And the Jags now with 11. Milton will bring it up. Full court pressure by the Jags. Swings it over to Curry. Gets it across midcourt to Harris. And he kicks it down to Doss. They're going to reset. Doss pulls it back. Kicks it in to Curry. Out to Milton. Shot clock at 8. Milton over to Doss. Thought about the three. Pulls it. Has it stripped away. And it goes over to Southern. They're going to push on the fast break. Attacking is Whitley. He decides to pull it back out. 3:25 remaining in the first half. Nice move, but not able to hold on to it. Gets it out to his teammate. Three-point shot is short. Rebound, Bram Harris. He's going to push. Gives it to Doss. Doss goes up, has it knocked away. And that block.
There's a foul call.
Oh, they didn't hear the whistle there.
Yeah.
The foul called on Bryon Whitley. That's his second personal. That's the 18th foul.
Coach Woods is actually on the floor right now. I guess he called a timeout.
It's a media timeout on the court, so we'll take one as well. 27-11, our score. Golden Lions lead with 3:14 remaining in the first half. We'll be back with more on the Reliance Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and Deltaplex Radio's 99.3 The Beat. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Golden Lions holding on to a 27-11 lead. Ron Barbley here alongside Carlos James. Lady Lions with a big win, 70-53 in game one of this doubleheader. And the Golden Lions have led since inception of this ball game.
Absolutely.
And they hold a 16-point lead as Sean Dawes Jr. will head to the line for two. Dawes with 9 points thus far in the ball game. And the shot is good. And I believe they're talking to Coach Sean, but of course Sean Dawes is at the line.
Yeah, but so they are talking to Coach Woods.
So Dawes with one remaining. And he knocks it down. Sean Dawes Jr. with his 11th point. He leads the Golden Lions in scoring.
And he's tied with Southern.
Yes, he has as many points as the entire Southern University team.
Yeah.
Jags will swing it around the perimeter. Motion offense. P.J. Bird with it. Guarded by Bram Harris. Bird is going to attack. Pulls it back out. He'll swing it out to Rollins.
They're making everything so tough.
Williams. Nice shot there by Terrell Williams. 29-13 now our score. Again, full court pressure.
Nice screen right there by Curry.
Ball inside to Plett, who goes up strong. Strong move by Ishmael Plett.
Yeah, great job right there.
His 6th point of the night. 31-13 our score. That almost was a travel there. Here's Lyons. He's going to attack. Curry with great defense. Plett getting a hand in there. Yeah. They're going to get him for the foul. So Ishmael Plett with his second personal foul. So Tyrone Lyons will head to the line. As I think I'm missing a foul here. I only have 6 team fouls for the Golden Lions. As Lyons is able to knock down the front end of the 1-1. And it's actually the 7th team foul in the Golden Lions. So Lions will have an additional free throw. And it rattles out. Sean Dawes Jr. with the rebound. Full court pressure, swings it into Milton. Milton's gonna push out to Harris. Harris out to Curry, and they'll just reset with Dawes out top.
You had 2 shooters in the corner, Green and Milton, was waiting for the ball. Nobody saw him.
Curry's inside to Dawes, takes the mid-range jumper and knocks it down.
Yep.
Sean Dawes Jr., 13 on the night.
He's down by 1 to Southern.
So here we go to the top. Shot is up, and the 3-pointer is good. That's number 11, Deshaun Woods, coach's son, with the 3-point basket. 33-17 now our score with 1.5 minutes remaining in this first half. Milton swings it out top. Dawes is going to take 3. Knocks it down. Sean Dawes Jr. from way downtown.
Fire.
Bang.
He's on fire. That's
get it
game.
To Dawes. Get the ball to Dawes. 16 points so far.
Yeah, he's on fire.
And he has the hot hand. Here's the drive. Left-hand layup. No good. Offensive foul called. And everything rolling the Golden Lions way.
Yeah, definitely that. Definitely that.
So the offensive foul called on Isaiah Rollins, his first personal. And that's going to be the team's 9th foul. Player control, so the Golden Lions will just take it out of bounds.
And Dawes wanted to come out of the game. And Coach Solo gave one of those looks like, you better not.
Right, you're the hot hand. Yeah, right.
That's with 1:17 to go.
Right, get him the rock right now. Milton inside, trying to get it to Dawes. Had it knocked away. Dawes sitting in the middle. Small lineup for the Golden Lions right now. Bram Harris takes the 3, and he's going to be short.
Oh, Curry, that was kind of ill-advised right there.
Yeah, fighting for the rebound, he knocks over. And nothing here. I think everything is okay. The players tell him it's okay. It wasn't nothing malicious there. He was fighting for the rebound.
Yeah. But if you sell it, you're trying to find anything to kind of fire you up.
Right,
you're
absolutely.
Get right there, especially if, right before the half.
And if you're UAPB, you're trying to do everything you can not
right.
to rile them up.
Exactly. You just want to keep doing what you do.
Playing sound basketball. So they may take a look at this play just to be on the safe side.
Yeah.
And that's what you'd like to see. You want the officials to get the call right.
Yeah.
As they will take a look at that last play. We'll take a 1 minute break and we'll be back with more. Golden Lions lead 36-17 with 1 minute remaining in the first half. This is the Reliance Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and Delta Breaks Radio's 99.3 The Beat. We'll be back. The H.O. Clemens Arena as we're just about ready to resume action. Officials taking a look at that last play to make sure it wasn't anything more than just a common foul. LeBron Marbley here, Carlos James inside the H.O. Clemens Arena and trying to get a few scoring updates for you. In women's action, let's see, they should be about done at this point. Final score, Jackson State over Bethune, 82-60. Alcorn defeated FAMU 72-60. Of course, UAPB over Southern 70-53. In overtime, Alabama A&M over Texas Southern 72-69. Also in overtime, Alabama State defeated Prairie View 77-74. And Grambling defeated Valley 71-57. Again, that was women's SWAC action. As we resume action, and the free throw front end of the 1-1 is good by number 23, Bryson Etienne. He'll have one shot remaining. 36-18, 18-point lead for the Golden Lions. And the second free throw is no good. Rebound, Chris Green. And Southern will drop back to a 2-3 zone as we'll try to get some NCAA SWAC men updated scores for you. In the NFL, Chiefs lead the Jaguars 27-17 with 4:18 remaining in the game. Shot is missed. Rebound, Southern.
First miss by Dolph seemed like today. Oh, and a three.
Zach Reinhardt is going to get called for the foul. 3-point shot is made. That's Reinhardt's first foul. And with this much time left on the clock, you do not want to see that. 3-point shot knocked down by Bryson Etienne. And you have a chance for a 4-point play here.
Yeah, you want to let him go ahead and just shoot that.
Right.
If you're not in position to challenge it.
And the 4-point play is good. And again, 35.4 seconds remaining. You don't want a mistake like that, but want to finish strong here going into the half. Milton has it. He'll set it up out top.
That's the second screen that Curry has set that's been punishing right there.
2-3 zone. Golden Lions just swinging it around the perimeter.
Yeah, you're just trying to milk some clock, get into halftime. You played a good half of basketball.
Bram has it stripped away. Bram Harris. Here comes the Southern with the fast break. And they're going to get Milton with a blocking foul.
Yeah, Milton was inside the restricted circle right there. If he was just probably about 6 more inches outside, probably would have got that call. Just didn't get a chance to set his feet.
As a result, Deshaun Woods will head to the line. The redshirt sophomore from Lexington, Kentucky. First free throw is up and good. And the Jazz. Jags slowly chipping away at the lead. 36-23 now our score.
You know Woods is going to make them. He don't want to hear dad. He's got to hear coach and dad. You
right.
Know?
All the way from the locker room to the house.
Yeah.
He knocks down the second free throw.
Like, boy, come up here and sit up here on this bus.
Here's the final shot by Kylan Milton. Short. It's no good. And we're at the half. Golden Lions lead 36-24. We'll take a two-minute break, and we'll have stats from the half, scoring updates, and more on their Lions Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports. Our score at halftime, UAPB 36, Southern 24. This is the Lions Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and on Delta Flex Radio's 99.3 The Beat. We'll be back in 2 minutes. Back inside the H.O. Clemens Arena. We're at the half. LaRon Marvin, Carlos James. And let's go over a few of the numbers, Carlos, if we get the band in the background. Golden Lions shoot 48% from the floor in the first half.
From the where?
The float. The floor in the first
F-L-O.
Half. Jags shoot 29.2%. So that's definitely a great sign. And majority of that is due to the defense of the Golden Lions.
I mean, the Golden Lions have contested every shot, every dribble, every pass. And, you know, what Coach Solo always say, you know, good defense turns into great offense.
Right, right. And they have 8 steals in that first half, causing the Jags 13 turnovers, so a great number there for the Golden Lions. Sean Dawes Jr. has been a story if you're talking about scoring for UAPB. He was 6-6 from the free throw line. He was 2-3 from behind the arc, 4-6 from the field. So Sean Dawes Jr., I mean, just taking over the ball game early on.
Yeah, Sean Dawes has, you know, we talked about him. He's matured so much coming back, you know, from SIUE, and he just kind of lets the game come to you. You look up, he's like, wow, he got 16 points. At one point, he was only down to Southern 17-16.
Right.
At one point. So he's done a really good job. Can't say enough about Trajan Ware, the way he's run the point guard spot to allow these other guys to be able to do the things they need to do.
And just a side note, Sean Dawes, the only player in the entire ball game that's in double figures right now. And the Golden Lions, you look at one of the numbers, or a couple of the numbers, the turnovers, 10 for UAPB, 2 for Southern University, points in the paint, 0 for Southern Golden Lions with 16. So those are some very important numbers.
That's huge. I mean, it's one of those things where, you know, just like what Coach Thorne did in the first ball game, you want to try to extend the lead to put a team away. You want to do it from the inside out. And then the other thing, just to point out, the Golden Lions are shooting 9 of 9 from the free throw line, 100%.
So that's definitely a great number, and it contributes to the Golden Lions 36-24 lead at the half. As we see some of the administrators and coaches getting their UAPB gifts, some nice jackets there.
They are pretty nice.
How could I get one of those?
I'm kind of jealous.
Right, how could I get one of those? We're at the half, folks, here at the H.O. Clemens Arena. Our score, Golden Lions up over Southern University 36-24 with 10 minutes outside of the second half tip-off. So we'll take a break, and we'll be back with more on the Reliance Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports. Again, our score at the half, UAPB 36, Southern 24. We'll be back with more on the Reliance Bank broadcast. Golden Lions Sports, UAPB Sports Network, Deltaplex Radio's 99.3 The Beat.
Once again, can we give Jeremy Washington and Carter Washington to the ticket booth? Also, the UAPB Golden Lions football team will be collecting coins for the student advisory committee. If you see them, please give what you can. Also, we need Deron Barnes to please report to the scores table. Deron Barnes to the scores table. Jeremy Washington and Carter Washington to the ticket booth. Are you living the three-star guy?
back inside the H.O. Clemens Arena. Just underway here in the second half. Southern has the possession. They take the first jumper. No good. Rebounded by Robert Lewis. Golden Lions holding on to a 36-24 lead with 19 and a half minutes remaining in this ball game. And it's been all Golden Lions here early on. Laron Marbley alongside Carlos James. And Carlos, man, this has been an exciting one so far.
Great game right now. Just can we continue to do what we've been doing? Defend, defend, defend.
Absolutely. Trajan Ware has it on the right wing. He'll set it up. Drive baseline. Goes reverse layup. Trajan Ware with the pretty move.
Oh, nice.
And I love it. The 5'9 guard.
Right. I was going to say that. Who say you can't play basketball at 5'9"?
That's right. Amongst the trees. Here's a deep three-pointer. No good. And a whistle. It had to be on the rebound. So that's against Robert Lewis. That's his personal foul. The 6'9 freshman from St. Louis, Missouri. Of course, we saw him in the King Cotton Classic last year playing for Cardinal Ritter. And great story there. As we resume action, Trajan Ware is going to be called for the foul. But great story there. Coach Bozeman came out to the King Cotton to check out some of the action.
Right.
He offered the kid right there at the King Cotton Classic.
Yeah, and then got him to come. And that's another good thing. So the King Cotton has been paying dividends.
Absolutely. Inbound to Lyons. He has it, swings it over. He's going to cut toward the basket.
He ran.
He did. That was like a reception.
Yeah, he ran to the basket.
So Lyons able to make the layup, and he's been the leading scorer for Southern. Pass inside to Plett. No good.
You got to make those.
Have to. Nice pass. Rebound Southern. They'll bring it up, trailing by 12. Swings it over, down to the corner. Here's the baseline drive, reverse dunk, missed. And that was Terrell Williams with the missed dunk. Trajan Ware grabbed it, but he travels, and it goes back over to Southern.
That's one of them plays. He tried to do too much right there.
Right.
He wanted to get the dunk, but a layup would have cut the lead to 10.
Shot clock, 20 seconds on it, 18-23 in this second half. Golden Lions, 38-26 lead. Here's Etienne. He'll kick it out top. They swing it over to P.J. Bird. Motion offense. Here's the jump shot from downtown. It's good. That is Brian Whitley from downtown. Lead is now single digits. 9-point advantage for the Golden Lions. Swinging it out. Pass almost tipped there into the hands of A.C. Curry. Chris Green has it on the baseline. Squares up, looks, bumps in. And here's a shot by Chris Green. It's good.
Wow. They let him play. Letting him play.
And he did give him a bump, but I think it was a bit of an acting job there as he flopped pretty hard to the court. Here's a drive, give and go, and another left-hand layup is good by Tyrone Lyons, and they seem to find something there on that backside.
Yeah, Lyons has been the catalyst right now, trying to keep Southern in the ballgame.
Timeout, Golden Lyons, and the zone has not fared them well here early on in the second half. The lead has been cut to 9, 40-31 on this media timeout with 17-23 remaining in the ballgame. We'll take a one-minute break and be back with more on the Reliance Bank broadcast from Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and 99.3 The Beat. and the fans want to know, who are you rooting for? The UAPB Golden Lions holding on to a 9-point lead, 40-31, with 17:23 remaining in the ball game. And we were missing our hecklers there for a moment. Yeah, they're back, so they played an important role in that first half, I believe.
Yeah, they took a break. The Southern kind of come back when they left.
Right. So we're back to the action. Golden Lions on possession. They'll inbound to Kylan Milton. And Southern in a zone. Looks like an extended 1-3-1 matchup zone. As Milton has it, swings it over to Ware. Moving the basketball, Milton attacks, goes up, shoots the jumper, and it rolls off. No good. Here comes Southern. Golden Lions struggling just a bit here to score in the second half. Again, they gain the lead by defense. Here's a three-point shot, and it is good. And here comes that run we were talking about from Southern.
Yeah. Down to six.
Bryson Etienne knocking down the three-pointer. Chris Green has it, throws it down low, inside to Plett. Strong move, Ishmael Plett. And a much-needed basket by the Golden Lions.
And that may be the way that the Golden Lions can kind of keep the lead right there down low.
Here's the drive. This is by Etienne. Drops it off. A nice pass. And the layup is made by Terrell Williams. And again, the lead cut to six. Milton has it. Swings it over. Dolph started about the three. He'll kick it back out to Milton. Ware has it on the left wing. Cross court to Doss. Doss attacks the baseline, goes up strong, misses. Nice move by Sean Doss, but not able to finish. Here comes Southern. Pass to Lyons, he's taking the three. Misses, rebound Plett. Milton has it, kicks it over to Plett. Plett back out to Milton. He'll just reset. 15:45 remaining in the game.
The main thing is just don't panic right here.
Right.
Just don't panic. About getting a bucket. And you can't have that right there. He's where stepped out of bounds.
Right. You don't need any unforced turnovers, definitely. Media timeout on the court. We'll take one as well. 42-36 our score. Golden Lions hold on to the 6-point lead with 15:43 remaining. This is the Lions Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and Delta Flex Radio's 99.3 The Beat. We'll be right back. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You hear the crowd here. They are involved in this ball game, Carlos, and it's been a great one. It's been a great atmosphere in front of a packed house. And I'll tell you what, Lady Lions with the big win. Golden Lions coming out on fire. Struggling a little bit right now, but we expected that. Of course, a team like Southern under the direction of Coach Jones, you know they're going to make their run. You just have to sustain it.
Yeah, I mean they're not 5-0 for nothing.
Right.
You know they're going to play really good basketball. They're going to give you all they got.
And they have it on this possession. Nice block there by Sean Doss Jr. And an offensive foul called at the same time as Chris Green hit the turf pretty hard there. That offensive foul called on number 22, Brian Whitley. That's his third personal foul. And that's the first team foul of this half. Green appears to be okay, as he slowly trots down court. And Milton will bring it up. So 42-36 remains the score here. Milton has it, gets a screen from Green, and that's going to be an offensive screen. And that was a great call. Either way, Green trying to explain to Milton, but either way, the screen was not going to be legal.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, that was almost like a crackback.
And you know those are illegal now.
Right, that's even illegal in football. So.
Yeah, that's why some of us are crazy.
Right, to this day.
Crackback blocks.
That's the 13th foul on the Golden Lions in this half. Trajan Ware, mismatch. Inside pass is good, and the bucket by Terrell Williams.
Green was trying to let Milton know he had backside help right there. And gave up the easy layup.
Golden Lions lead is now cut to 4. Trajan Ware drives, turns it over, and here comes Southern. This is Whitley, takes the 3, no good. Rebound Sundahls Jr. He's going to have to slow it up as 4 Jaguars get back. Doss isolates.
I think you got to keep attacking right here. That's what got you the lead.
Right. Trajan Ware with the crossover. Screen from Chris Green. Kicks it out to Milton. Milton steps on the sideline.
We've seen a lot of that this year.
We have. And that's just court awareness, knowing where you are on the court. It's Ishmael Fletch returns for the Golden Lions. And Deshaun Woods returns for the Jaguars. 14-20 remaining in the ball game. Golden Lions holding on to a 4-point lead, 42-38. As you hear the crowd chant, defense. We'll see if the Golden Lions can do exactly that. Here's a 3-point attempt. Way off. Rebound Ishmael Plett. That shot missed by Etienne. Almost stolen there. Gets it to Dawson. Here's Milton for 3. Knocks it down.
Big time
Kyler
shot.
Milton from way downtown. Much needed basket by the Golden Lions. Here's the answer. And it is answered by Bryson Etienne.
Yeah.
And he knocks it down.
Yeah, he's shot the ball well.
That's his 9th point. He's now tied with Tyrone Lyons for the Jags' leading scorer. Of course, Dahl still leads for the Golden Lions, and in the ball game, he has 16. And we'll take a mid-range jumper, in and out, rebound Jags.
It's going to be a good one. This is going to be a good one.
Here's Sean Jones. He attacks, gets it over to the Etienne. He kicks it back out. 3-point shot is up and no good. Rebound Bram Harris. That shot missed by Etienne. That was Deshaun Woods. Check that. And another turnover. And here comes Whitley.
Can't let Woods take that shot.
And he knocks it down.
Yeah, you can't let Woods take that shot. You get a coach's son wide open on the baseline, he's going to knock that down.
So the lead is only 1 for the Golden Lions now. 45-44, 12:45 remaining in the ballgame. Jags have clawed their way back into this ballgame. Trail by as many as 20 points at one point.
Yeah. 20-point lead has evaporated down to 1, but hey, there's still no time to panic. Just Golden Lions just got to continue to attack.
Well, it's up and a foul called. This was against Deshaun Woods. That's his first personal and the second team foul.
Hey, you just got to keep playing because you know they're going to make a run, you know, and it's to be expected. If you want to be the king of the hill, you got to be able to withstand runs anyway.
So, Dawson, we're here to the line.
And I ain't never seen nothing in the rule to say just because they catch up, they're going to win.
Right, absolutely. Absolutely. And Doss remains perfect from the free throw line. As Isaiah Rollins returns for the Jags, Doss has 1 shot remaining. 12:29 remaining in the ball game. And Doss misses the second, rebounded by Rollins. 46-44 our score. Golden Lions hold on to the 2-point lead. The Jags have come firing back here in this second half. They move it around the perimeter. Golden Lions in a zone defense. Extended zone is swing cross court pass. 3-point shot from the corner. No good. Rebound. Ishmael Plett gets it out to Kylan Milton. Goes to the cup and up and off the glass. They fouled him on the floor. And that was on number 11, Deshaun Woods.
Coach Woods was wanting to travel, ended up getting a foul.
So exactly 12 minutes remaining. Media timeout on the court. Golden Lions lead by two on their Lions Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports on the UAPB Sports Network and Delta Flex Radio's 99.3 The Beat. Arena, as you can hear, it is rocking here. Check it out, folks. As we prepare to resume action, we have a delay of game warning against the Jaguars. It took a little bit too long there as we're ready to resume action. 12 minutes left in the game.
Yeah, it looked like the bench scoring, the bench scoring of Southern have 17 points off the bench has gotten them back in the ball game.
Compared to the Golden Lions, only seven.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Here's Dawson in the post. Makes a move, and he's going to be fouled. And that one's going to be called on number zero, Terrell Williams. That's his second personal. And that's going to be the third on the Jaguars.
And this is the type of game you really expected anyway.
Right.
With Southern coming in here, UAPB got off to a great start. But you know, like we talked about before, they was going to come back. But this is the type of game you was looking for anyway between these two teams.
Absolutely. Sean Dawson able to knock down the first free throw.
And if you got to get an edge, you know, I think with the crowd, I think, you know, the edge goes to UAPB right here.
Dawson with the second free throw. And he extends the lead, 48-44, just under 12 minutes remaining in the ball game. Jags wasting no time. They get into their offense. This will be Jones guarded by Ware. Great defense there by Trajan Ware. That should have been a five-second call, I think, Coach Bozeman was looking for. Here's the moves. A couple of dribble individual moves. Swings it out and throws it away. That's going over to the Golden Lions. And we'll see if UAPB can steal the momentum back here.
Yeah, you know, one of those things, too, though, you know, if you ever been on that side of trying to catch up and you get close and you don't quite get over it, that can take a toll on you as well.
And it does. It takes a toll on you just to claw your way back.
Yeah.
You expend so much energy to get back in the ball game. A lot of times you don't have enough to finish.
Right.
So hopefully that is the case here.
Yeah.
Here's Milton. He has it. Drives it. Going to the cup. Kylan Milton.
That's what Bozeman.
Slamming it home.
That's what he wants out of Milton right there. That's
great
what he
move.
Wants out of Milton.
Strong finish, Kylan Milton with the jam. 50-44 our score. Golden Lions on top. Motion offense by the Jags. They swing it around the perimeter. Three-point attempt is no good.
There's
rebound.
Crowd.
A.C. Curry.
Crowd's in it.
Trajan Ware swings it over to Curry. Now he's going to take a three, and the nets are hung. Ishmael Plett with the rebound. Kicks
Shoot.
It back out. Inside to Curry. Pump fake. And they're going to get him for traveling. Got a little bit excited. He did a great job here defensively. But again, the crowd playing a crucial role here tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
As the Golden Lions hold on to that 6-point lead. 14 fouls for the Jags, 3 for the Golden Lions. As this will be Deshaun Woods bringing it up. He's guarded by Ware. Swings it over. Milton defended. He'll hold Rollins. They'll kick it back out. Really, they're almost stolen there. Rollins able to corral it. Pump fake. Attack to the basket. And the shot is good by Brian Whitley.
The Curry nearly got that one.
Almost. 11 points now for Whitley. Curry's just a split second late on that block. And it allowed Whitley to score. Ware kicks it over to Milton. Fakes the pass, shoots the three, no good. Tipped by Plett, saved into the hands of Southern. Here comes Rollins. He gets it down.
Oh, he walked.
Whitley passes out to Rollins. Three-pointer, no good. Rebound, A.C. Curry, and the Golden Lions. Doss has it. Gives it to Ware. He takes a three. It's a little bit long. Rebound, A.C. Curry. Pump fake goes up to the reverse layup.
Nice.
And it's good. A.C. Curry, the Denver, Colorado native. That's my nephew's homeboy.
There you go.
A.C. and A.J.
A.C. and A.J.
52-46, Golden Lions lead. 9:25 remaining in the ball game. Back cut. Ball is lost. And it travels out of bounds. Yep. And it went off the foot of the Golden Lions, so it will remain with the Jags.
Well, Milton did a good job of saving himself, grabbing onto the nets. He was in the air, and somebody went under him.
Right.
He grabbed the nets and saved himself from a horrible fall there.
So 52-46, our score, 9:21 remaining in this ball game.
Some good stuff coming out of that.
Yes, great stuff. Harris will defend. Jones has it, swings it back, loses the handle.
Back court.
It's Lions, and that's going to be a backcourt call. And it goes over to the Golden Lions. And you see the team, the Jaguars, fussing at each other, and that's what you want.
Yeah.
You want to disrupt the chemistry, and you want to steal back the momentum, which the Golden Lions have at this point.
Just like we talked about, you know, you spend all that energy trying to catch up, and then you really never get over the hump.
Right.
And the Lions is kind of still extending the lead right now. That's tough on you. Need a basket here, though.
6-point lead for the Golden Lions. 9 minutes remaining. Ware over to Milton. Milton back to Ware. Ware pump fakes. He's going to drive. Kicks it out to Harris. Bram Harris for three. A little bit long. Chased down by A.C. Curry. Nice offensive board.
Gotta
Milton has an open three. Knocks it down. Kylan Milton from way downtown. Bang.
Big time shot right there.
Here comes Southern. They're wasting no time. They're going to attack. Here's a 3-point shot up and no good. By Lions, rebound Bram Harris.
Yeah, if you coach Woods, you might want to get a timeout right here because their team has did everything they can to get back close. Now the Lions are beginning to pull away.
9-point advantage for UAPB. 8:20 remaining in the game.
It's a big score right here. It'll seem like 20 if they get a basket here.
Don't let it be a three or a dunk. The crowd will erupt.
Oh, yeah, this place
Milton to the cup,
crazy.
Swings it out. Kicks it out to Bram Harris, takes the three, and right at the shot clock buzzer, no good. In and out by Bram Harris.
Good shot, though.
Was.
Turnover. There you go.
And it goes back to the Golden Lions. Under 8 minutes remaining, so immediate timeout, 55-46 our score. Golden Lions on top here on the Reliance Bank broadcast of Golden Lions Sports. It's the UAPB Sports Network and Reliance Bank broadcast on Deltaplex Radio's 99.3 The Beat. We'll be right back. We'll be right back. back, ladies and gentlemen, inside the H.O. Clemens Arena. 9-point advantage for your Golden Lions with 7:58 remaining in the ballgame. Golden Lions shooting from the field, 46.3% clip. And that is great for the Golden Lions. If you look at Southern, they're shooting at a 36.4, which is up from the first half. And Golden Lions, again, starting to pull off again here in the second half.
Yeah, it's been they've been closing the gap on the bench points. So at one point, it was 17-7, 17-12. And then also they're shooting 12 or 13 from the free throw line.
And that's a lot to Kylan Milton, who takes a three-pointer here. Shoots it a little bit short. Tipped by Bram Harris and A.C. Curry. A.C. Curry will chase this one down. And Coach Jones does not like that one.
Coach Woods is really upset.
Yes.
He's going to get a replacement. Not grabbing the rebound right there.
Here's Milton. Attacks. Kicks it to Ware. Attacks. He's going to get it to Harris. Takes a three. Knocks it down. Harris.
Big time shot. Just two shots right there by Harris.
So a 12-point lead for the Golden Lions. 7 minutes remaining. Ball tipped away. Remains with Southern. And again, the defensive intensity is turning back up to much like it was in the first half.
Yeah, yeah. You know, Southern was trying to climb that hill, man, and they got to the top and met defense.
Didn't know it was on the other side of that hill.
Right.
Southern inbounds. Again, with about 7 minutes remaining in this ballgame. Here's the attack. Swings it across. Fakes a three. Pump fakes. Kicks it back out top. Here's a three-point shot. No good. That shot missed by Etienne. It goes out of bounds off of Southern. Go to Lions ball.
And if you coach Bozeman, you got to be pleased with your team. You know, they withstood the run, and then now they've increased the lead. That shows some maturity now.
It does. Kylan Milton brings it up. With 6:40 remaining in this game. Swings it across court. Harris back out to Milton. Curry flashes down the lane. He doesn't get it. Harris going to attack the baseline. Swings it all the way over. Out to Curry. Shot clock down to 7. Golden Lions taking their time there. And that should be a foul. Good call there as Ware was knocked out of bounds. He's kind of bumped out of bounds. That was going to be on number 12, Jalen Reynolds.
And Milton drained a would-have-been three, but the thing is, I'm looking at with him shooting that shot and it's going in, you know, he's a guy you need to get the ball to with Dawes sitting on the bench right now.
Absolutely. Him or Harris at the point.
Yeah.
Harris has a hot hand right now.
Exactly.
So Ware will bring it out. He'll get a screen from Ishmael Plett. Plett rolls. Milton attacks. Drops it off. And yeah. Offensive foul called on Kylie Milton.
That was a hard fight. The Southern player hit his head on the floor there. PJ Bird. And they may need to check him out because he did hit the back of his head on the floor right there.
Sean Dawes Jr. enters. And you're exactly right. Anytime you hit your head, I thought you – well, I know in football, you know, if it's a collision or something like that, you automatically have to be checked. But they're going to let him remain in the game. 6:15 remaining in this ball game. 12-point advantage for the Golden Lions. And here's the Jags. Nice play run on the curl. Great defense. And they're going to call Milton for a foul. He got it caught in no man's land. Nowhere to go. They're going to call Sean Dawes for that foul.
I thought that was a great block, actually, by Dawes.
And I think he was bailed out there.
Yeah, if anybody fouled, it would have been Milton.
Right.
Because Dawes went straight up and got the basketball. Nevertheless.
But obviously, they didn't call it on the shot. They're inbounding, so.
Right.
Here's the attack. Basket no good. A battle for the rebound ends up in the hands of Dawes.
Good job by Ware. He stuck his hand in there and kind of dislodged the ball a little bit.
So under 6 minutes remaining, 12-point advantage, Golden Lions. Kylan Milton has it. Jags in his own defense. Milton swings it over to Dawes. Thought about the three. Kicks it back out. Dawes goes baseline. Here comes the double team. Back out to Milton. Spins. Swings it over to Ware. Ilibaez pass there, though.